Okay, let's try this again. It helps if I have the earbuds plugged into the computer.
Whatever you do, stay away from that black door. Being near it chills you to the bones.
Okay, so hopefully I'm not going to get feedback. So if she's telling me about a black door, I don't know anything about a black door yet. Is she metagaming?
They say the college has been snooping around Sarthar. Mages.
Oh wow, that's... I've only heard that twice now in this playthrough. In other playthroughs, I've been told maybe 30 times about mages snooping around Sarthal. So I guess this version of the unofficial patches is playing yet again with the weights.
It's something we often used at home when we wanted to talk and we were in a hurry. We call it the quick chat horn, and it's bit complicated to explain what it does. Therefore, I've also written everything down for you. Anytime.
Now I lost my train of thought.
Are you hungry? I could make a meal for you if you like. Well, if you say so. Talk later.
Pretty much, if I know enough about how Skyrim's programmed, the dialogue topics, the rumor mill, I guess. When you click on an NPC and they say something about something they've heard going on in Skyrim. The chance of them saying the same thing over and over and over again depends on the weight, the priorities of the topic. So I'm guessing each topic has a weight to it. And I guess the unofficial patches have been playing with those weights again. Because I'm also not hearing a lot from guards saying about the, a Dawn Guard is reforming. I only heard that maybe 3 times in this playthrough instead of 30 times.
What makes this smell? Kill!
But if you give everything little weight, then I wonder what NPCs will talk about. Like, what has more weight than if you assign less weight to topics that were talked about too much? NPCs will start talking too much about something else.
Yes?
In Oblivion, NPCs would say the same thing to each other that they would say to you. So chances are, if a...
Maybe we could make a snob. Of course.
You know, if a... if a noble never told you something, chances are they're gonna...
Continue?
You'll hear them say it to another NPC. So you'll still get to hear about the rumor that's going on in Cyrodiil. You know, I'm just running around looking for wolves, vampires, werewolves. Okay, now where are we? Oh, this is over at the mill by Solitude.
mixed up. What is it? Let me know if you need anything.
Yes?
I don't know if you can tell in this light, but
anytime.
I finally got around to fixing my
Let's get going.
Depth of field.
Let me know if there. What can I help you with?
So now faces are in focus when I'm looking at somebody.
Thanks again for your help.
And stuff in the background is blurred.
Can I help you? Let me know if you need anything.
I had gold deer with me when I was another dragon. Was that another dragon that I jumped over? Yeah, I was using him to test out mods with. I was installing mods, removing mods, trying out mods. So this became a save area. I would keep coming back here when I would remove a mod. So I don't think I recorded this too many times. Otherwise it would feel like a loop. A Groundhog Day.
Where do you want to go? Climb and back and we'll be off.
So I'm trying out different companions that I found on Nexus. And I'm trying to remember how to turn the light off on my face.
This whole country's full of them down south.
I don't need face light on myself. Okay, so now we're back at Dawnstar again. So who's with me this time?
So, where are we going now? Shall we continue? So, what would you like to do next?
I'm just seeing how blurred the background is behind you. Uh-oh. She won't hold still for my experiments. No, it doesn't look like any other vampires are around here. It must have been a fluke. Unless it's that traveler dude who doesn't make a big scene. He just kind of walks around until you bump into him. Sometimes there's vampires over here fighting with bandits, but I don't see any screaming and yelling going on.
You're not from here. We don't need to be talking. Damn it, man. Are you trying to taunt us?
Now it's going on.
Our daughter, Fyodra, was taken from here. The Forsworn descended and they didn't touch anything else, just our little girl. It was the Forsworn from Broken Tower. Never been much trouble before. What's it to you? That's good of you. If you were to save her, I would be very grateful. I don't think there's anything I could give you, though.
I was curious, if I didn't mention Dibella to him, would he then know about Dibella and the whole Sybil thing afterwards? And sure enough, he knows all about the kid needing to
Please,
be the new Sybil.
Open the door. I need to get out of here.
Okay, why are you walking like that?
Are you one of them? Please don't hurt me.
What's going on with you?
All right, then.
Oh, sorry.
Are you one of them? Please don't hurt me.
Maybe there's like a wall blocking her from coming out.
I've heard stories about the wonders of the Great Temple in Markarth, but I never dreamed that I would even get to see it. I am honored to be called for this duty. Please, lead on.
She talks like she's,
Please, let's hurry to the temple before the Forsworn find me again.
Like a reincarnation of a Sybil or something. I'm looking for... Oh, there's some snowberries. I was looking for snowberries on the floor. Usually there's a pile of them here. But I did see one in the corner in my eye. Because that's weird, because this place doesn't reset except for it puts Forsworn back in here, but like this chest never wants to reset. Stuff I've taken off this table never wants to reset. Snowberries never come back on the floor after you take them. At least in my setup. It's just this room though. All the other rooms in this fort get reset. And then I notice right away she's got this space age fabric she's wearing. Super glossy. Clear coat sprayed on it. I don't know what. She's got like a vinyl see-through bag shrink wrapped around her. I don't know what that's all about. But it's just that, I want to say it's just that outfit and another outfit that the females wear in my game. It's got this reflection set up on it.
You haven't forgotten about the ingredients you promised to help me find, have you?
I don't know which,
Please, let's hurry to the temple before the Forsworn find me again.
Thank you for getting her back from the Forsworn. Dibella was smart to have sent you.
I want to say it's the mothers and daughters mod that's messing up the dress.
Dear, did they hurt you?
Of course not. My spirit remains strong.
See, they don't look at each other when they talk.
Do you know where you have to go?
I'm to go to the temple in Markarth. I'll have to leave you and Mother.
It's our honor to have you.
They must really hate each other.
Are you ready?
Of course.
Yeah, he doesn't even look at her.
Please, lead on.
You would think that the unofficial patch would have fixed that by now, but no. It's probably not a bug. They really do just hate each other. I don't have to bring the daughter back here to say goodbye to the father, but I thought I would just to see if he knew what was going on. And sure enough, he already knows the whole story. He knows all the plot about the Sybil and the Dibella and all that kind of stuff. And I thought I cleared out this mine, but I must have gone back to a previous save, so...
If the Forsworn aren't attacking my town...
Robbery is what it is. Forsworn attack the mines, and suddenly all these sellswords show up to help.
Yeah.
You can try, but I'd keep your sword arm ready if things get ugly.
Yeah, I've already done this. I'm just gonna do it again real quick. Just so the universe is copacetic. Why am I barefoot? Oh, I must have been sneaking around. I take off my boots and I'm a perfect sneak. No one hears me coming. Even if I'm not sneaking, just running around barefoot, I can still get by with my stealthy maneuvers. Okay, let's just outright kill this guy here, if I can. I remember clipping. Someone was standing behind me, or I was clipping on crap, and I couldn't back up when I needed to back up.
Oh, you
over here.
Yeah, I'm like clipping on tables and crap. Oh! I got this exploding wolf thing that has a short fuse. I have to run away from it, otherwise it will blow up in my face. Yeah, I had done this quest before, but then I had to go back in time. When Vilya was messed up, she had a broken.
My sword.
Another day, another victory.
Oh, the guy followed us out. Okay, and her outfit is still reflective. Okay, so I need to find out what mod messed up her outfit. It's not supposed to have shine to it, or reflection to it, or whatever.
If the Forsworn aren't attacking my town, the Nords are trying to force me off it.
Who's pushing me?
Good day.
Well, the kid is.
I'm one of the few native sons of the Reach that owns land. Doesn't make me very popular.
That won't be the last we hear from the Silverbloods, but at least we can get back to work. Thank you. You've done a good thing for me and my workers. Here, this is for you. Hello, friend.
Take care, friend.
I think I changed his outfit. Yeah, I'm sick of this outfit. So I gave him the other fancy clothes. There we go.
All right, then.
I'm still barefoot. Yeah, Vilya had messed up earlier in my playthrough, so I went back in time and to when she was working, but then she was still broken, so. I like this. Huh?
You found her.
Yeah.
I can't believe it. Let the girl come with me and we can begin her preparation.
She's just sitting there.
I will send word to her
family
that she is.
What was she doing? Just looking at her empty cup of mead?
You truly earned the blessing of Dibella, child. Prostrate yourself before her altar, and she will bestow her gift.
Oh, she doesn't even have a cup. She's faking her meal.
Ouch! Stepped on my toe.
Too many people in here. I want to steal this blue thing. Can't see squat. So I can't take anything from here? I'm not a friend of anybody? I brought a frickin' Sybil to your place. There's no, Dibella statue, because I took that. I think I still have it in my inventory. No one wants to buy it.
I'd better get going.
It's not worth anything.
Make it quick.
It's just a cheap knockoff. Let's give her a different outfit.
All right, then.
She's the ringleader, so she gets to dress more appropriately. So where's the kid? Where'd the kid go? Oh, can I steal these soul gems? Everyone's freaking watching me. Oh. Where are you going? Don't tell me you're going back to your folks' house. Hopefully they've made it so that this is their home now. That's all I need is a brat running back and forth between here.
Leave me alone. Just leave.
What's that about? What's going on? What? Did she see me steal something? I couldn't read what that said there. Say something about I have to pray at the Dabella altar or something. Oh, where am I supposed to click? Oh, there we go. Let's take a picture of this. Anyway.
Good to see you. You've come to the right place. I'd be happy to teach you.
Okay, she's not trying to kill me then. So she likes that I brought back the kid.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. See you.
And I gave the kid a robe, or a, what do they call this, a priest outfit. I used to have a mod that would
need something.
Make the kid put
now,
on the robe
if you'll excuse me.
When you brought the kid here. But I don't know what mod that was. I want to say it was Cutting Room Floor that did that.